On behalf of Netflix Geek, welcome all humans, dwarves, and halflings, especially you creatures at home who are Stranger Things super fans like me. You're in for a special Geek Week treat. Today, I'm sitting down with the Hellfire Club themselves for a one-of-a-kind Dungeons & Dragons adventure. I'm your host and Dungeon Master, B-Dave Walters, and the adventurers joining me on today's quest, none other than Finn Wolfhard, Priah Ferguson, Gaten Matarazzo, and Joe Quinn.
The hooded cultists chant, "Hail, Lord Vecna."
Vecna's dead!
He's killed my cat!
So it was thought, my friends, so it was thought. But Vecna lives!
Today was supposed to be a good day. After years of grand adventuring, you're returning home to Hawk's End. Each of you has made your way through the world, carving your legend into history. Goblins, giants, ogres, trolls, dragons, all manner of monsters have fallen before you. Again and again, you've won, cheating death itself. And today, death has come to collect.
Okay.
Our heroes, pardon me, Belchin. Joe Keery, Chad Handstand, and Lady Applejack. You see home in the distance. Hawk's End is a small, beautiful town. It sits on a little island in the middle of the river as the water flows around it on all sides, creating kind of a natural boundary. There's only two ways in, a bridge to the north and a bridge to the south, surrounded on all sides by luscious forest. As you see home in the distance, you can already catch the smell of baking bread wafting on the wind. You hear children laughing off in the distance and can see the smokestacks rising out of familiar sights of home. Just north of Hawk's End, there's a ranger station, a guard post that you have to check in as you four heroes come walking up. What would you like to do?
Who does it start with?
Whoever would like to. You all, the four of you, are walking down the road.
I'm assuming we have like passports and stuff, and the documentation to get on through. Right. So I guess we're gonna go up to the ranger station and. I don't really seem to have a lot of charisma here, but I'm gonna be like, can I get through?
You know, important question here. What does Pardon Me Belchin look like? Who is he?
Pardon Me Belchin, he's a smelly dude. I mean, he has to kind of like, it wasn't his given name, but like he came up with it later in life and thought that it would be a good thing to like, just set the boundaries of what interacting with him might be like. So smelly dude, he's not the brightest. At least people around him don't think he is. And he's kind of accepted that throughout most of his days. But he enjoys an adventure. He enjoys a good bar fight, I'd say. And he, above all else, enjoys family.
And you're a dwarven grave cleric. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so he's a morbid one. Some would say it's a sense of humor. Some would say it's just weird.
As you call out down the road, from inside the booth, all of you hear, you four back again, huh? And a head leans out, a familiar head that you've all seen, of an unpleasant bugbear named Gloom. Bugbear is kind of a deceptive title. They actually look more like large predatory cat people, similar to a tabaxi like you, but honestly, the comparison would be a little offensive, and you and Gloom have never really gotten along because of this. He has black hair that is knotted and kinked and has twigs and muck in it because he's never overly concerned with his appearance. Thought you all were off becoming legends. You know, I hear the stories all the time of, Chad Handstand held a handstand. Whatever, who cares? Why are you back?
Hungry. Tired.
Supplies? Do we need supplies?
You know, important question, Joe Keery. What does Joe Keery, the Tabaxi Gloomstalker Ranger, look like?
5'11", brown eyes, sunny disposition, great chat, wicked sense of humor. Although apparently he's got no charisma or intelligence, which is kind of interesting.
You speak a different language.
Kind of thing.
Now, you're a cat person, so what does your fur look like?
What would Joe Keery's fur look like? Just perfect.
Flowing.
Yeah, it just looks just right.
Mm-hmm. What color?
Kind of brown, kind of like mousy.
Right.
But kind of like oily, but it kind of not too oily. It just looks nice.
And what does Lady Applejack look like?
She's an ill.
You are an ill assassin rogue.
Yeah.
The most dangerous.
Yeah, the most dangerous.
It says dark ill, so mm-hmm. She's you a dark ill.
Applejack, yes.
Mm. Very sneaky.
Perfect.
Yeah, I think she's killing it actually because she doesn't want to give too much away.
Exactly. You say you'll find out.
She doesn't want to give too much away.
Last but certainly not least, Chad Handstand. What does he look like?
Well, he, he's not the most strong guy in the world, but he is. He's got some. He's pretty big. Yeah. Mm-hmm. No. He's kind of like the skinny strong. You know, he's not like super maxed out or anything, but he's like. He's like a Robert Pattinson kind of type,
gotcha.
But like in that kind of way, you know, like a scrawny yet strong.
Now, you're a human paladin, but you, what you are lacking in charisma,
okay.
Joe.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Chad took all of it.
Chad took all of it,
he's beautiful. The wind is always blowing perfectly in his hair. The sun is always hitting him just right.
Must be nice.
He got the name Chad Handstand though because you know he was at a funeral and everyone was crying.
Of course.
And to cheer everyone up, he said, "Watch this." And in hindsight, it might have made everything inappropriate. Might have made everything about him, but he still did the handstand. And from that point on, he was known as Chad Handstand.
Did it kill? Did people like it?
Well, technically it killed. It wasn't a funeral, but. No, it didn't kill. No one liked it, but he kept that. And from that moment on, he kind of, he just became.
So he thought this went terribly.
So he's
I'm gonna keep doing this.
He doesn't really know. So he doesn't. He can't read people as well, but that makes him very confident.
Oh,
cool.
Gloom still hasn't forgiven you for doing a handstand at his grandmother's funeral. So yeah. He comes out of the road and he stands nearly 7 foot tall, towering.
He's a big guy. He's
I hate to admit it, but it's probably good that you're here. There's been some difficulties as of late.
What's up?
You know, you probably should just make your way into town, I guess. Astara, she's at City Hall. She'll explain it all to you. Just do what you're gonna do and get out of here soon. The town's better off without you.
This guy.
Thought he needed us.
Okay.
I don't, I'm fine. Oh, they need you.
He said Astara?
Astara.
Astara.
Astara. Mm-hmm.
So we've gotta go and see Astara. Mm-hmm.
You all know Astara. She is an elf. She has been in charge all of your lives, all the way back when your grandparents were children, because elves are very long-lived.
Okay.
Yeah, whatever. And Gloom goes back into his shack and slams the door behind him.
This is a problem.
What? You got a problem with me?
I think he liked it.
I don't.
I'm not jealous. Okay. Yeah, I don't care if that's what you think. It's not that
it
at all.
Sounds like he's kind of jealous. He wants to be a part of the group.
No, like you guys like went to do your thing. Some of us had a duty to home and stayed here to keep track of
you. I wonder why you're by yourself. It's just like, what are you doing?
That's unnecessary, okay, Joe? Like, I mean, you just got back. Just like, oh. I like being by myself.
Yeah.
goes and slams the door again. And ahead of you stands the bridge to cross over into Hawk's End.
Okay. So we should probably cross over that bridge.
Let's go cross over that bridge.
Let's go find Astara really quickly because I'm not really feeling this right now. I'm tired. I need a drink.
Yeah.
As you guys come walking in, again, you all have been all over the world by now, but there's nowhere like home as you come back. Again, there's fresh apple pie sitting on the windowsill. Children running around have tiny carved figurines of each of you. One of them comes running up to you and says, Minta Belcher, look, and holds up a very poorly made dwarf wearing your signature magic shield.
I gotta admit, that's cute.
Yeah.
Beard's off.
Dad, the beard is off! And the kid turns and runs back into the house.
The beard was off.
The beard was off. Dude, listen, it's totally fine. You put him in his place. It's totally fine.
Was that really necessary?
Astara?
Yes.
Astara.
Yes. Well, come, darlings. Let me see you. And she walks up to you, Applejack, and she says, you look incredible.
Aw, thank you.
They haven't been giving you too much trouble, have they?
No, not at all.
Really?
Maybe this one.
Yeah. You know, you've been going easy on the ale, right?
Yeah.
Kind of looks you up and down, and she's like, are you sure?
Well, it's hard to travel with that much, so I kind of ran low.
It's like
pretty
a
early
lot of excuses.
It's
enough.
Get you
all right?
Some
I've been working on it.
Yeah.
A window nearby of the tavern swings open, and Stella, a little halfling. She's about 4 feet tall with frizzy red hair. Hi, would you like a pint is what you'd like?
Very much so, thank you very much.
Pints for all, pints around, eh?
Yes, Stella.
Yes. And the star looks and she says, wait, business first, pints second. I assure you, we've made all of your favorites. She leans in close and says, I haven't wanted to alarm the townspeople, but something has been amiss lately. Someone has been robbing graves in the cemetery.
What?
Yes. Every morning we wake up, there are fresh holes and the bodies are missing.
I worked so hard on that.
I know. It was a lovely ceremony, and thank you for your restraint for minimal handstands.
Can you believe that? Seriously,
I've heard about it.
I'm trying to lighten the mood.
It doesn't always need lightning.
Not always.
Your father was the same way. Always cartwheeling during funerals.
My father was a handstand. His father a handstand. His father before him a cartwheel.
Yes,
but
I remember I saw them all.
So what did we ask? Oh, no, what are we going to do then?
This hits close to home, so I'm furious.
You're furious.
I offered prayers to the morning Lord Lathander that help would arrive, and sure enough, the four of you return home. It must be meant to be, right?
Yes. I'd say so.
That's what's meant to be is these points is what you're supposed to be.
That's what's meant to be.
Stella, my God, it is so good to see you. What has it been, a year?
That's more than that, lad. Yes, look at you, so beautiful. Okay. Why is the light
We'll pick up on this later.
Always hitting you perfectly.
Back to business.
Stella, just save the
seat, please. Okay, fine. I know you've been traveling. I'm sure you're weary. We made sure that all of your houses are prepped and cleaned.
Thanks.
Have a drink, have some food, and then it's going to be dark soon. Maybe take a look.
Okay.
At the cemetery?
Yes, please.
Great. That sounds not spooky whatsoever.
Well, I'm thinking, I'm there every day.
Are you
it's
afraid?
No.
I think he's afraid.
He's not afraid.
That's why he never visits me at work. Seriously, he makes me come to him afterwards because he never wants to come.
Just as an aside, you are a paladin. Not only are you literally incapable of fear, as long as your friends are around you, they're incapable of fear well.
So you're lying.
You literally have a radiant aura. It's unfair, really.
Yeah, my friends love me. So, I don't know. It's kind of great.
We'll have a couple of drinks.
Should we have a few drinks? Maybe there's a few people we can talk to in the tavern.
Get a little loose and then go check out the
pregame. We'll pregame.
What do you think, Lady Applejack?
Yeah, I agree.
We're going to go and have some drinks then.
Perfect. I'm going to rally the town watch, make sure I've had people watching all night recently to see if they could spot anything. You all indulge.
Wonderful.
And then come back and find me, okay?
Perfect. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good to see you again, by the way. Sorry, we were really grumpy.
No, it's...
We're tired.
Thank you. I'm sorry about the ale comment.
No, don't you worry about it.
You look wonderful.
I understand.
You do. It's not just about you.
No, my wife says it all the time. I get it. It makes sense.
As you make your way into the tavern, Stella has laid out a buffet spread that probably could feed 20 people.
Or just one of me.
Or two of you. She's at least doubled you.
Well, at least I'll take half.
There's assorted roast beasts, pheasant, pig, there's pies, cakes, anything that you could dream of. All of your favorites have been made.
Great.
Mm-hmm. Yum,
yum. Ah, welcome back.
Stella.
She's just worried about everyone. You know, that's her job, really, to just keep an eye on everything.
Stella, this pie is, I mean, these desserts look beautiful.
Tuck in, enjoy.
How'd you get this gammon like this? How'd you get it like that?
That's the secret family recipe. I got to keep some things to myself,
you know. If I had to twist your arm, bro.
It's only a little bit. No. You never know, I might like it.
I get really quiet because it's really awkward because Stella and him had a thing.
Had a little bit of a moment.
Strange things happen once you've had a bit of ale. You never know till you try. You all enjoy yourselves.
If you need anything, I'll be here. Just...
You live in the mood.
Cheers, everyone. Cheers.
Cheers.
Delicious.
Amazing.
Lady Applejack, while they're all eating and drinking and rambling, you hear... coming from the kitchen where Stella just went.
Oh. Well, I want to investigate.
Mm-hmm. Are you going to tell your friends that you hear it?
I think we do. What do you want to do? What do you want
to
do?
Once she calls your attention to it, what would you like
to
do?
What do you hear?
I want to go investigate.
You want to go investigate? What happened? What'd you hear?
I heard someone in the kitchen. The kitchen that Stella went to.
Stella?
Yeah, someone was choking. Like
what?
I hear.
I thought that. Wait, no, we have to go find.
I thought that was beatboxing.
It started as a beatbox, ended as a torturing thing.
Regardless, we should investigate.
We should go. All seriousness, Stella might be in trouble. We should go.
Or someone else.
Pardon me, Belchin. You, as a grave cleric, you chose that name, man. This is your doing, not mine.
I love it so much.
Because again, Gaten was taken as a well-known demigod of entertainment and performance.
Gaten?
Yes, literally.
The Almighty.
The Almightiest.
The Almighty.
Yes. Peace be unto him.
Yeah. Pardon's a fam.
You, as a grave cleric, have an innate connection to the weave of life and death.
That's fun.
In understanding anything that defies that link between life and death. Wow. You have an innate sense for the presence of the undead.
Seems things quite wise for one of his background.
You are as wise as it gets, honestly.
Amazing. That's great.
And one thing you realize, there are undead in this building.
Okay.
You feel it.
Yeah, I thought I had some goosebumps before, but I thought that was just me, like, getting really excited about
the fizzy ale.
It turns out
it's the undead.
It turns out it's zombies.
Is that what that was?
Is that zombies?
That's what that was.
Wait, okay. Well, if you're hearing that, I thought I felt something before. I think we got...
Things are adding up.
Here, I'm going to go to the kitchen.
Are you all concerned? Yes, gonna check.
Nothing like that should be happening anywhere near here, especially not Stella, our good friends. So I'm gonna go to the kitchen.
Perfect. As you push the door open, on the ground, you are confronted by a horrifying sight. Stella.
Yeah.
You think it's Stella.
Stella?
It's a Stella-shaped something.
Oh my God.
He's wrapped in what looks like rotting meat.
I'm pissed.
And as you notice, coming out from under the tables and ovens, what looks like skin that has been pulled off of the bone is sliding forward.
Oh, God.
And I'm gonna need all of you to roll initiative.
Ooh.
So, on your sheet, you should have an initiative there that'll be plus something.
I just rolled it. I rolled an 18.
Did you really?
Yeah. You're
very fast. And you actually.
I see. I rolled a 1. No, I rolled 7. Sorry, I rolled a 7.
I rolled a 15.
15. Lady Applejack.
11, I think.
11?
Yeah, I think.
Perfect. And I'm going to go for the monsters there. Joe Keery. Like, you are actually
feels
first.
Great.
It feels so good.
Yeah, it feels good. How does it feel to be Joe Keery?
It's great.
Wonderful.
These boneless abominations are crawling out, coming from each direction, and one of them is apparently smothering Stella to death. What would you like to do?
I'm gonna kill it.
Okay. Want to shoot it with your bow?
I want to shoot it with my magic bow.
You do have a very impressive magic bow. It is a dragon wing long bow. So when you draw it, it looks like a dragon's wing flexing, and flames erupt around the arrow as you shoot.
That's badass.
First, roll your attack for me. You are very, very good with this bow. Now, for you in particular, you are what is called a gloom stalker. So this is when you shine, when you are ambushing. In the first round of combat, you actually get to attack more times and you hit harder.
Hey.
This is something specifically
there
you do. This
there
is
you go.
Your
in
specialty.
There. Get in there.
So what'd you get on that first one?
I got 25.
Perfect. You actually get to attack 3 times. So hit it for me 2 more times.
Oh, where?
21.
21, also gonna be a hit. Give me one more.
One more. It's 26.
Again,
that's
it's
huge.
You very rarely miss. Just to give you an idea, 30 is godlike success, and you got a 26. So these are very precise. So they're under your damage. You're gonna click that for me 3 times.
That's 12.
12.
Whoa.
Again.
Again.
That's 11.
11, whoa. Perfect.
12 again.
You come in and 3 flaming arrows go and slam into this thing, and it unwraps there on the ground and stops moving. And you see Stella looks up.
Stella,
oh, there's more of them! Is there anything else you would like to do?
Did you guys see that?
Yeah.
I think that was cool.
That was cool,
that was
yeah.
Good for you. That was awesome.
I'd like to comfort Stella.
Perfect. She very much is holding on to you and Lady Applejack.
Okay.
He has shot the first one of these, but it looks like there's 4 more in the room that are crawling out. What would you like to do?
I want
to
stab him.
I want to stab him.
Always the right answer, Lady Applejack.
So funny.
I want to stab him.
You, as an assassin rogue, you are particularly good at attacking something that hasn't had a chance to act yet. Basically, like, you catch things flat-footed and gank them is really your thing. So, next to your weapon there, there's going to be a plus. Go ahead and click that for me there. It'll be a plus some number. Your weapon is called a rapier of wounding. So you have a magic sword that when you hurt people, the wounds don't heal.
Yeah.
So
you got a perfect hit.
There you go. So you did this the best you possibly could
that's
do.
That's incredible.
As you, I'm not even gonna make you roll this because I know how hard you hit. As you lunge forward, actually, you tell me, would Lady Applejack explode this thing, or is she so precise that it's just like a little hold in and out?
I feel like she'll explode it.
Yeah?
Yeah, like.
Just go in.
Do it!
Oh. Go for it.
Well, this thing already didn't have any bones, but Lady Applejack lunges forward and it essentially explodes as a splatter against the wall. And you can still attack again because you killed the first one in 1 shot. So go ahead and give it to me again. That's fantastic.
24.
Luck. 20 out of the way. Yes, more than enough. All right, so click on that number there next. That'll be 1d8. You see that there? Click on that. I'm going to roll your sneak attack damage for you here, so you don't have to worry about it. How much damage did you do?
9.
How much, sorry?
Nine.
Nine?
Mm-hmm.
Perfect. I'm waiting on your sneak attack to come through, because it is a lot of dice. You have 7d6 that you roll for sneak attack, which is a lot, like a lot. The first one explodes in a flash. You're on the second one and stab it and just stops moving.
I love it.
There on the ground. Unfortunately, it is now the Boneless's time to attack. And they do not take too kindly to what Joe Keery has done.
When does anyone ever?
That is true. And unfortunately for you, Joe Keery, I also rolled a natural 20.
Oh!
So, Joe, as you are comforting Stella, and she's like, no, right by! You all see the Boneless wraps up and begins squeezing Joe Keery for 10 points of damage.
Oh.
So you keep track of that, and you all see your friend is being squeezed and suffocated. You are still pretty stout, you're still in the fight, but you have been harmed. Lady Applejack, another one does the same thing to you, having just obliterated two of them. One falls from the ceiling and wraps you up and falls to the ground and starts squeezing you as well
you guys
for
gonna
10 points of damage.
Give a second. Mm-hmm. Any point?
That's,
Are they gonna help?
Hopefully.
Okay.
We're gonna see. Yeah.
10 points of damage.
10. 10 points. Sir Chip.
There you go.
Perfect. Your friends got off to a really great start.
Right.
But now they're kind of having some problems of their own.
All right.
What would you like to do?
I'd like to save them, but I also know I want to know what the hell is going on, too.
You're just gonna leave.
But I wonder, because, here's the other thing. We killed them, you guys killed them, without even trying to speak with them. Do they speak? I guess we'll
see. They have not made any noises outside
of
this, like,
tamper
weird
with the shit, dude. I've seen this stuff all the time. I sense this stuff.
Okay, so I'm gonna play it safe and save them.
Thank you.
Try to save them.
Go ahead and roll your first attack.
Okay. I
can't believe it.
You, as a paladin, you are a holy warrior, so you have the ability to do something called a smite, where when you hit them, you can basically set off a divine explosion of damage.
Rolled a 3.
Unfortunately, you have to hit to be able to smite. So, Sir Chad, as you're basically trying not to accidentally cut the head off of one of your friends here, which one of them are you attempting to save? Not to make you pick favorites. It would be weird if some sort of monster presents you.
In my head, I was closest to Joe.
Perfect. You know what? Let's roll the physical dice.
Okay.
Okay, grab one of these D20s.
Yes,
that's the one. And roll it in the box here in front of you.
In this one.
Yep.
4. Are you?
You know, however, you have a pretty significant bonus. That may be enough. Let me see. That's rough. Believe it or not, you were such a capable warrior. That is enough to hit it with your. You have a pike, a long, sharp spear with a hook on one end that you stab into it. Now, important question, would you like to use your smite?
Absolutely.
Perfect. Again, I'm going to roll that for you here because you also do quite a lot of damage, honestly. So I'm going to roll that for you. You roll the damage for me where it says that 1d10 plus 6.
Should I do it on?
We'll do the physical dice. Okay. You want a 10 side.
Oh, is
one of these ones. Looks kind of.
Oh.
Like a dime.
Yep.
This one?
Yep, that's it. Roll that one.
One.
You okay?
I'm fine. Soaked up
I'm fine. You might not get in there. You might not be fine.
That is true. Actually, he's going to be okay. It is you who. There is one other ability you have, just for your own
Let's keep trying.
Edification. Yeah. No. You've hit it.
Okay.
You also get to attack a third time because as a polearm master, you stab twice and then hit with the butt of the weapon. So roll that 20 for me again.
Which
that one right there.
This one that I'm holding.
That's the one. Yep. Okay. Roll it.
Are there multiple d20s on the table?
Yes, there are two.
Oh, got it.
Each of you have two. You might even have four.
I think I have a lot, actually.
Four. Again, that actually is enough.
Yeah, okay.
You have a pretty significant bonus, so you do hit it twice. Now,
sweet.
Would you like to smite it twice? Would you like to set off your
magical
power?
I would love to smite it. I would love to smite it.
Love to smite.
Joe Keery.
Hi.
you're being strangled to death. And your friend very ineffectively swings the first time, and the second time, you're pretty sure he's about to cut your head off as it's coming down, and at the last second, there's a blinding flash of light, and the boneless is smeared across the wall, exploded.
Sorry, it was a struggle for me.
Pardon me, Belchin.
Yes.
Yes. There is one of these things left.
Yeah, there is.
Mm-hmm. What would you like to do?
And it's messing up her,
it,
right?
It absolutely
well,
is.
Well, I know that the first priority is making sure that everybody in my group is safe, so I'm going to try and get it off. I'm going to try and attack it and
perfect.
Get it off.
Would you like to hit it with your mace, or would you like to cast one of your spells?
What are my spells?
Your guiding bolt is kind of your main thing.
I see that. What can I do with my guiding bolt?
It is a blast of energy that you will shoot out. If you hit, not only will you damage the target, you make it easier for the next person to damage the target. That's how
guiding
bolt works.
Yeah, I'm going to go with that. I'm a team player. Okay, cool.
Click that plus next to guiding bolt.
Guiding bolt. Mm-hmm. I roll a 19.
That is more than enough to hit.
Perfect.
So, you know what? Let's roll some more of these physical dice.
Great.
Four of those D6s. Four of the square ones.
Got it.
Yep. Roll those.
All together.
Roll them all. Yep.
Woo! I got a 3, 3, 3, and a 5.
So 14. 14 points of damage. That does not quite
finish
it off.
Okay.
It does not quite finish it
off. Okay, that's fine. That's fine.
But because you cast a spell, that is actually the only thing you can do is cast
that's
a spell.
That's okay. I'll cast that spell.
However, Joe Keery.
Hi.
Now, the one remaining boneless is glowing with light around it, giving you an opportunity to finish it off if you want.
I'll finish it off.
So, you are going to roll.
What if we can learn something?
Can I talk to it?
It has not said anything.
I don't think I want to kill it.
Yeah. Okay. So, because he hit it with a guiding bolt, you have what is called advantage. You get to roll two of these and take the higher one. So, roll two of these 20s for
you're welcome.
And you take the higher number between the two.
13.
13, that is more than enough
it is.
With your you bow. And then you're gonna roll one more time for me for your second arrow.
12.
Again, more than enough.
We've got this.
Two more arrows. And the flames start igniting and burning its gross undead form.
Gross.
And Stella is just sitting there shaking, covered in goo. Like,
I don't know. It's okay. Calm down.
Baby.
Very much buries her head into your, quite frankly, furry chest. And all
she
of
saved
you
that.
Give me perception checks again. Perception checks.
Okay. Perception checks.
Yep. Under your skills, you're gonna roll right next to it. And it's gonna go,
I rolled a 10.
10.
A 10.
Not noticing too much. It's in your skills.
13.
Yeah, 13, perfect.
I have rolled a 14.
14, all right.
13. Oh, 19. Oh, 19.
19, yep, because they added to it. As Stella is kind of freaking out a little bit here, Sir Chad.
Yeah.
Outside, you hear screaming.
And footsteps.
Whoa.
Yeah. Footsteps and screaming.
Yeah.
From nowhere. Footsteps running away from the screaming.
Yeah, sure.
Yes, coming from outside the cabin.
Okay. Well, I'm going to go see what's going on outside.
Be careful.
Oh, yeah. I will. Okay. I'll try.
As you run outside, it's terrible. From the water that is surrounding Hawk's End, you see undead are coming out of it. Zombies shambling forward, waterlogged, but not just zombies, hearts of zombies. There's arms and hands that are just disconnected from anything else coming up out of the water onto the shore. And the people of the town are screaming and running. Some of the watch have pulled out swords and bows and are lighting up torches. They're kind of no match for this, though, Sir Chadwick. So, what would you like to do? Whoa, are you gonna tell your friends?
I'm gonna go and let them know that there's a horde of undead coming towards us.
Thank you.
Guys, yep. There's a horde of undead coming towards us.
Are you serious right now? Yeah, the moment I've been waiting for.
They're coming from the water.
Coming up out of the water. Perfect. But they all seem to be coming sort of from the northeast side of the water.
Okay.
All coming out that way.
Okay.
Forgive me, but you have a tendency to be able to. You didn't see this coming at all. You couldn't sense this.
You don't understand.
That army.
You can't. Like, you don't understand how this works. It's not. Okay. It's not like a spider sense. It's more of like. It's more of like, I can't predict what's happening, but I understand when something is happening. So right now, I'm off the walls. Like right now, like my chest, you wouldn't even believe. It's like a major anxiety attack right now. Okay. And I would appreciate if you didn't make fun of me.
Can we get you something?
Just more beer.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, you. Grab a go cup, yeah.
Okay, are you all gonna have something to go.
You all gonna head outside?
I'd like to head outside.
Yes, Lady Applejack.
I think I might stay.
Did you say you want to stay in here?
Yeah, I want to stay.
You're going to chill out in here? You're not going to go help?
Did you see what happened last time?
So, you, Lady Applejack, are incredibly sneaky. So if you want to skulk around outside, there's a pretty good chance no one can see you if you do.
Yeah, I think that's what I might do.
Do this for me. Roll one of these 20s for me.
Okay.
We're going to see just how good of a job you do sneaking. Yep. Mm-hmm. Roll that for me.
Okay. Great.
So here's the problem, Lady Applejack. Never know if you're doing a good job or a bad job, right? Okay. So you all have your friends, the lethal assassin, who's like, just kind of goes stomping out,
skipping,
believing she's a ghost.
What the hell is she doing? What is she doing?
Oh my god! Great.
So embarrassing.
What do we do? What do we do now? What is she doing?
Ghost. Nobody's ever gonna see you.
All right. Well, now that she's gone, what are we gonna do?
Would you all like to head outside?
I would love to head outside. Okay. I need to go outside.
We should face this.
Yeah, absolutely.
Head on.
A quick thing. Am I allowed to ask Stella what is going on?
Oh, absolutely. Roll your insight.
Okay,
for me.
I'm going to roll my insight.
In your skills, there's an insight. Roll that one.
10. I rolled a 10.
What would you like to ask?
Do you know the Muffin Man? No, do you know, have you seen these kind of monsters before? Or do you know what's happening?
Why would I know what's happening? You're the adventurer,
Okay, all right. Jeez, time to go outside, I guess.
I'm just going to barricade myself. Actually, I don't want to stay in here. They were in here. I'm going to barricade myself out in the town. That's all right.
Okay. You should stay there.
She's a mess, but good try, though.
Thanks.
Joe.
Hi.
Make sure you return to me.
I will be back.
Come back.
I just need to go sort this out.
Please, yes. Okay. As you guys come out, you see the scene as described. Okay. Undead hordes coming out of the water.
First thing I think we need to continue.
No, what were you going
First
to
First thing I think we need to do is try to get everybody out of here. Since they're coming from the northeast, I say we rally the towns and get them off the south bridge.
Perfect. What would you like to say? What are you gonna tell them?
Guys, look at all this. It's not coming from over there. Run that way. If you can barricade yourselves in houses, do it. Right. If you can make it to the bridge, go. Don't worry about supplies. We can rally that later. Just get out of here. South Bridge. South Bridge.
And I know what you guys are thinking. Yes, I did have a night out with Stella, but that's not the point.
We can figure it out later.
Okay, fine.
South Bridge. I think Stella should join.
Stella, you go too, babe.
South Bridge.
You do
South
see,
Bridge.
Again,
everybody evacuate.
You all are legends. So amazing. Just by raising South your bridge. Voice slightly, amazing. Everybody heads south.
Got it.
That Perfect. Way there's no collateral damage when we try to kick ass.
Perfect.
Good job.
Thank you.
Brilliant plan.
Thank you. Where's she? I don't know where she was.
No, she's pretty.
She's playing in the water. She's making a sandcastle.
Right. However, I'm going to keep you guys in the same order that we were going before. So, that would make it your turn.
Oh, God. Good.
Again, there's zombies everywhere. Mm-hmm. What would you like to do?
stab him.
Jeez. You never go wrong with stabbing. Yeah. If you want to do something else, you can, but you know, that's...
What is that something else I could do?
Check like your...
You are very... Well, your skills...
skills.
You're very good at sneaking. Well, it's supposed to be. You're very good at disguising yourself, making you look like someone else. You can actually turn invisible if you like. That's wow. a thing you can do.
Yeah. That'd be fun.
Ooh, yeah, I think I might can I turn invisible and stab them?
So, yes, but if you stab them, you will reappear. You will stay invisible until you attack someone.
Oh, okay, then I might just go invisible.
Okay, yeah. And disappear for the time
being.
Thanks
for the help.
So while she's stomping around,
she's
really
testing it out, I guess.
You take care of disappear. Yourself.
Whatever. Okay.
Mm-hmm. I gotta put me first.
Very valid. You know, you gotta find the commander, right? That's the thing you do. Perfect. Lady Applejack turns invisible.
And she makes a cool sound as well, apparently.
That is true. That
cool.
Is,
she was just gonna make a sandcastle.
Right. That's how good she is. Oh, you know? Man. She can make sandcastles and just be gone. Yeah. Then gack.
That's crazy.
Sir Chad.
Yes.
Your friend has disappeared.
Yes.
The townspeople appear to be listening to you, heading south. Mm-hmm. Again, there are undead hordes all around you. What would you like to do?
Could I use my athletics in some way? I'm sorry.
No, please.
I just got another thing.
Yep.
Can I pretend to be a zombie and try to like follow them to wherever they're going?
You could.
Because my perception's pretty.
You're a pretty seasoned adventurer though, and the undead are very dumb. Like they,
okay, okay.
They just,
they're not going towards anything.
They thirst for the living.
Okay, okay. Yeah, okay. Right. I just in case I needed to go undercover.
Super
in some
logical.
Way. Mm-hmm. Okay. So this might be an attack situation. Can I use my athletics in any way?
So what athletics will let you do is if you want to grapple them, like if you want to grab one and wrestle it to the ground. I will tell you, just for your own knowledge, something that is just dope that you've got, is you have a spell called Find Greater Steed, where you can summon a magical creature to ride, like a griffin, a pegasus, a dire wolf, a rhino, a saber-toothed tiger. Like you can just summon something dope to ride if you would like to do that.
Can I attack while I'm on top of that on my next turn?
Yeah, that's cool. You literally have a
point. I'm gonna call a griffin.
You like a griffin?
Yeah.
What does your griffin look like when it shows up?
He's big.
Head of a lion, body of a bird?
Head of a bird, body of a lion.
Thank you.
With wings.
With wings?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Say like, head of a bird? You said head of a bird?
It's got an eagle head, a lion body, and
I was thinking like hummingbird, super long nose, like super sharp long nose. Ooh. And then, the body of a lion and big wings.
Like the buzzy wings, like a hummingbird?
What kind of wings?
Yeah, exactly.
Buzzy wings like a hummingbird.
It's a hummingbird griffin.
That's cool.
I feel like this is something Sir Jad's probably done before. Does it have a name when you summon your humming beast?
Roderick.
Roderick the humming beast, perfect. Yeah. I love it. I'm gonna get Roderick in here for you.
Yeah. Do I roll for that?
Excellent.
This is what I do. Okay, got it. Okay.
Presumably, you want to hop on the back of it.
I would love to hop on the back of it.
Perfect.
Hey, bud.
Hi.
What's up, dude?
Hey. That's how it sounds. I guess I'm voicing both. Yeah.
You know, it's.
I'm so jealous of that Roderick guy. I wish I could. I wish I could summon that.
Stella can't fly, man.
Stella can't fly, but Stella can bring you warmth and love.
That's true.
It's purely transaction with Roderick.
Exactly. Like,
I pay him at the end of each ride.
No,
it's like it's basically an Uber. I pay him. It's a ride share.
It's a combat ride.
Yeah, exactly.
Pardon me, Belgian.
Nah.
What would you like to do?
Right now, I'm just sad right now because honestly, I see all this happening. These creatures are supposed to be resting. They're supposed to be. Mm-hmm. Like at peace, and right now they're not, and they're putting themselves and everybody else in danger, and I'm pissed.
You, as a cleric, mm-hmm. have an ability that is called Turn Undead.
Oh, you can revive them!
I might do it. I don't know what
you
it does.
You can just make them leave, and you're actually a high enough level cleric. You can make them basically force them to leave. And if they're low enough level, they will not just leave, they will be destroyed.
Okay.
By your holy intervention.
This is insanely convenient.
Yeah.
I mean, what a great
You're unbelievable,
guys, this is my element. This is what I need.
This is what we all need.
Meanwhile.
Sorry, where's Astara? Is she getting out with them? Because I feel like she should debrief with us, or did
she is rallying people,
she's
moving them
together.
Yes,
she's
helping us. Yes, she's listening.
Go, let her do that, let her do that.
Meanwhile, Princess Applejack's at like Disney World or something.
Yeah, where
like that.
I don't know where she went, but she's chilling. Okay, so right, yeah, I want to talk to these guys. I want to be able to communicate with them. I want them out of here.
Wait, so it is your intent to turn them, correct?
Yes.
You can.
What is that? What spell is that?
It is an ability that you've got called Turn Undead.
Perfect. Yeah.
Perfect.
I turn undead. Turn undead.
What? So you brandish your holy symbol, glowing, radiant. What do you say to turn these undead fiends?
Okay. I need to relate to them because they're just sad. They're lost. They don't want to be here either. And I say, guys, you have each other. You don't need this. This is something you've had before, but you don't need it now. You've moved on from this, and it's not healthy to be lingering here right now. I will guide you. I will be here to hold your hand, or your leg. You don't got hands no more, but I will be here for you. Well, I know. I know it's rough.
They like it. They like it.
I think it's best if you just go to sleep like you need to. You've had your time, and you can't take it from other people.
As you finish your heartfelt speech,
thank you.
As they are shambling,
You
all see, what color is the light that comes out of Pardon Me Belching? You're a grave cleric, you're a cleric of death.
It's
but
a
you
cleric
tell
of
me.
Death, but the thing is people misunderstand death. Death isn't scary, death is a part of life. Like mm-hmm. We're here all together and it's amazing, and so it's a warm sunset orange. That wafts as the day ends into a peaceful night.
As this light rolls out from you, you are strong enough that you will destroy all of these undead.
That
but
would break me. It would
since
break me.
You are coming from a place of love, and it is your intent to put their spirits at rest. Mm-hmm. That's what happens.
Yeah.
You all notice the zombies just sort of stop for us and just kind of lay down.
Amazing.
And die.
Wow.
All of them.
And I weep.
Didn't want to have to do that.
I didn't want to have to do that.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
And then I say, so are we getting another drink?
Unfortunately.
No.
God.
Pardon me, Belchin.
That's okay.
You get a sinking, sickening feeling coming from the south.
Mm. Where I told everybody to go.
You told everybody to go. It is almost like this attack came from the north.
It's a diversion.
To force everyone
it's
to
a
the
diversion.
South. What kind of monster would do such a thing?
Oh my god, what did I do? What did I do?
It's gonna be a bloodbath.
Guys, we need to go. We need to run. We
to
need
the rest
to get
of you,
our...
it's like, yeah, we won. And no,
we need
like,
to
we
go.
We're running. Can we get her back? Or is she kind of still?
Who knows?
Well,
where
you
she
hear
is.
All
I don't
of
know.
Her. She, I mean, okay. You're invisible, but yeah, you're there.
I don't know where she is.
They don't know you're there, but you know you're there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Lady Applejack's coming. She's coming. We're all going. We're running.
We
to
don't know she's here.
Can I say
invisible? Oh, of course, because she's invisible.
You can reappear whenever you want.
But can we call Lady Applejack?
Hi, I'm back.
Oh,
jeez.
Oh,
my God.
Did you hear that?
I heard everything, and I decided that I needed to help you guys.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Let's go?
Yeah.
As you all head south, right across the bridge, you see just on the other side of it what looks like a tear has been ripped into reality.
Great. Mm.
There is a jagged black line with black energy rolling out of it.
Hmm.
And all the townspeople are gone.
Oh. I'm gonna.
We've got to go through.
I want to go through.
We have to go through.
I love to go through.
I have to go through. I will lead the charges. What am I doing?
Should we shoot something into it first?
What if you hit one of the townspeople?
I'm willing to take that risk.
Just, instead of shooting an arrow, like.
Just chuck a stone into it?
Why can't we have Roderick
chuck a stone?
Go?
I could go in.
Roger can go in and then loop back. Go in and just zip around. Just check it. And
okay, I'll do a quick. What do they call it? Like, what's like a really normal thing? Like, you know when people are at a party and I'm like, I'm gonna do a little round. Like, I'm gonna do a round. Like, do the rounds. Yeah, I'm gonna do the rounds and then come back. Okay.
So you run and do.
I'm gonna run and do the rounds. Come back. See what the vibe is, and then if it's cool, you guys come in. We have drinks with the townspeople.
Okay, great. We got.
You're gonna fly in.
I will fly in. Yes.
Roderick flies into the
rift. Oh, I'm with my.
I mean, you're right. You are going with Roderick, correct?
Right, correct.
You fly in, and he doesn't come back out.
Shit.
We've been waiting for. He should be back by now.
He should be back by now.
Should we?
I guess we might as well. At least we know that everybody, like anybody who remained on, is anybody still here?
The town is apparently deserted.
Everybody.
Yes.
Wow. Can I call out to see if anybody's there?
The only person that is still there, even Stella went, because you sent her south too. Stella's gone.
Oh, yeah, we gotta go.
I can't leave them in there without me in there.
Any of the guards? None of the guards.
Everything's gone. Heck, we're inviting a third, okay? Right, guys?
Okay.
So I think we should all go in together as a team.
As a team.
Okay. Yeah. Glad you're here.
Thank you.
As you all pass through into this, immediately you're somewhere else. Hmm. It's cold. Like the winter time.
I wonder.
It looks like Hawksand.
I wonder.
But it's not Hawksand.
Great.
It's the buildings you recognize, but they are broken and dilapidated, overgrown with vines, like they haven't been lived in for centuries. The sky is black in everywhere in all directions.
I thought it was like four.
It looks hopeless. The only thing that you see, because the portal behind you has vanished, you do lay eyes on your friend Chadwick.
Hey, bud.
You did try and come back, but the portal was gone.
Yeah.
The moment you came through.
Oh, it's gone. We can't get back.
Oh, so we're stuck in here.
Great.
You are. Mm. And you hear chanting.
What?
Difficult to make out what's being said.
Ritualistic chanting? Or are we talking like, far, we're not gonna take
ritualistic. Yeah. It's an important point of clarification.
Yeah, no, it's true.
Is it far away or is it close?
It's difficult to tell. It's like it's coming from everywhere and nowhere all at once.
Oh,
yeah.
It's like an aura.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I gotta say, right now, guys, I feel worse than I ever, like, I feel horrible.
Should have stayed invisible.
I'm really anxious. I really wish I could just curl up in bed. I don't really feel motivated right now. Okay. And it's clear to me that there's something really dark and really bad here.
Mm. Not fun really having a manic depressive on your team, is it?
He is literally a cleric. Like, it's very emo.
Probably pretty hard to be happy. Probably pretty hard to be happy sometimes.
You all hear. It seems to be coming from all directions at once.
Hate that.
Hate it.
Finally.
Oh no, 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 no.
Oh,
no,
yes. You all have made your way.
Yep.
Oh.
What?
No.
No. Yes. Sorry, wrong direction. We're from the other place. Weird.
Oh, I assure you,
right.
Everywhere will be like this place.
Oh, no.
Good.
Well, that's great.
I guess we should get used to it.
Yeah.
The chanting gets louder.
Ooh.
And you finally can make out what they're saying. Hail Vecna.
Oh, are you kidding?
Hail,
man.
Vecna.
Great.
Yeah.
Okay. First things first, where is everyone?
You don't see anyone. Mm.
Stella?
Stella! Okay. Okay.
I knew we were going to get there.
No.
I knew
no.
It was coming. I knew
Shame.
knew it was coming.
No, you just
didn't
get to do
it. No, you do.
Just because you're an actor, you think you can do that?
I knew what this was when I introduced the show. It wasn't good.
Such poor taste.
You just couldn't help yourself.
I'm sorry.
Literally what the fans paid to see.
So
Stella
can
do this.
If she can, she doesn't respond.
So the Brando's not really like, it's not helping.
You just, I mean.
You wish you were Brando.
I wish. I can't breathe.
The halfling.
Oh, you know him,
good. That one is special to you.
She's a friend, yeah. Oh,
if you touch her, Vecna. I swear to God.
What?
Carrie.
Yeah, what's up?
How about we barter? I'll let the halfling go if you give yourself freely.
Well, I'll give myself up
I'm
freely.
I'm gonna give myself freely.
I'll give myself
I'm
up
giving
freely.
Myself freely.
I like.
No one asked you. Vecna, I'll give myself freely. Vecna!
In the sky, floating overhead, you all see a terrible form begin to take shape.
Look at that.
He withered.
That's embarrassing.
See how terrible that
form looks? Terrible.
He is withered and gaunt, pale, decaying gray flesh.
Gross.
With a white, milky right eye, and his left eye and left hand are missing.
It's a Visine.
You can see through his rib cage, almost through his body, in his flowing robes are open, and inside of him, inside his body, there's a book. A black book.
That makes me feel weird. That feels like an epicenter of all my troubles.
Let's
right
guess
there.
What the book is.
That feels like an epicenter of everything that's ever been wrong with my life.
You haven't read it?
Joe Carrie. You must think me a great fool. Prove your worth.
I want to shoot him.
Thoughts?
Yeah, with my bow.
With that kick-ass bow.
I'm going to shoot this. Touch my woman.
You know what? Let's go ahead and roll initiative one more
Let's
time.
Let's do it. Right.
Give me one of these dice, or you can roll it there in D&D there Beyond as you come face-to-face
initiative.
With
I rolled a
15.
Lord
Vecna. 15 for Pardon Me Belchin.
Five for Chad.
For Chad.
22.
Chadwick, yes, you are
25 for Carrie.
Oh,
22.
25.
Gianna's 25th birthday. 25 for Carrie.
Perfect. All right. Perfect. All right. You can go first. Again, as a Gloomstalker, this is when you shine, right at the beginning.
Yeah.
So you can attack three times.
Go for it. Just gonna go with the bow.
I'm gonna hit that plus 12.
We're
right?
gonna do this. It's Boom. Like, Gaten, if you yes. would, pull out a d6 and a d8 for me, please.
That's 19.
Let's see. Hang on. Let me make sure 19 is enough to hit him. It is not.
No.
The arrow flies what should have been center mass and just passes through his rotting, decrepit ribs and just flies right past him.
Yeah, but
then he looks at you and says,
pathetic.
But now he knows I'm here.
But you
can I go again?
Oh yeah, you get three total.
Come on, what are you gonna try again? What are you gonna get? What are you doing?
17.
That is also not enough.
Come on.
Flies wide one more time.
Can we focus in here?
Yeah, I'm focused.
Okay.
Well, you're the one
that
got focused.
It's gonna be a big number.
Okay.
Okay? Do you feel it?
I feel it.
Manifest.
I feel a lot right now. Manifesting.
Whoa,
big ass
number. We got some hand shaking here.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no, I hit the wrong thing.
That's okay.
Wrong thing.
That's okay.
Feel it.
27!
Yes!
Felt good.
Felt good.
Well now, Vecna.
Perfect. So, I'm gonna get you to roll your damage for me. But where's that 8 and that 6?
I got that 8 and
so
right
take
here.
That, and you're gonna roll that.
We manifested
also
it.
Also gonna roll
just
another
these
8. Can you give him another 8?
Another 8, you got it.
Yeah.
Right there?
You're gonna roll all three of those.
Perfect.
It's okay. a three. It's a six.
Perfect. 15. Perfect, perfect, perfect. That one does hit him right in the chest. And he just looks down at it and says,
fine, let's do it your way.
All of you.
It's a great line.
Roll Constitution.
Ooh,
save.
That's where I shine.
You are very good at this.
That's
on
where
that
I
very
shine.
First screen.
So 17. First
save. Screen. 17.
Perfect. 17 for Chad.
For right Chad. There. All of you do it.
Eight.
Seven.
Seven.
16.
16.
Good for you. You're in the zone.
That is not enough.
No.
Vecna raises his hands, and you all feel the life being sucked out of you.
Not again.
You flowing out.
Suck my life.
You all take 42 points.
What, all of us?
Every what? One of you. 42 points of necrotic damage.
Oh, it's, man, it's I'm now at 73.
It's a significant hit, a significant hit.
So what would I be at? I would be at.
Oh, no.
But Lady Applejack, it is your turn.
Okay.
That sucks, guys.
Wait, I'm sorry, on 53 now.
Mm-hmm. Lady Applejack, he is currently up in the air where you don't have an easy way to get to him. It's almost like he knows you're dangerous. But what you can do is you have a spell called Fairy Fire. What that means is you can basically light him up to make him easier for your friends to hit him until somebody finds a way to get him out of the air.
I'm gonna help you guys out. I'm gonna help you.
Honestly, appreciate it.
No, we do appreciate it.
He starts glowing and he looks down at his hands and he goes,
you've sent plenty of souls my way, Applejack. And now that you face Vecna, you don't have the courage to strike at me yourself.
Roasted!
Listen, I hate that guy. I hate that guy, but even he burned you. Even then.
Call an ambulance.
Call the, it sounds like you're crying, so call the whambulance. Because she's crying.
Would you like to do anything else, Lady Applejack? Until they get him out of the air somehow, it's going to be tough.
Why don't
you
stab it?
I mean, what else could I do? Like, he roasted me.
Would you like to try and find the villagers, maybe?
Oh.
Oh, yes.
Okay, perfect.
Go do that.
We'll take care of this. Yes.
roll with that 20 for me there.
Okay.
Here, roll one of those. Yep. Tell me what you get.
Ooh.
Oh my God.
You don't find anyone.
You know, it's all or nothing. You're hot and cold. I love it.
Oh my gosh.
The savagery of Vecna's roast, Lady Applejack, temporarily stuns you.
Yeah, you're like, whoa.
You can't see anything other than that was out of line.
Yeah, when someone makes a joke about you and you like take 5 minutes and you're like, that was mean. I can't move on from that.
In front of your friends in front of the village, I mean, he's gonna do that. Okay, perfect.
Wow. Got it.
got it.
It is, unfortunately, actually Vecna's turn.
No. Oh,
great.
Well, he is very powerful. That's why he has something called legendary action. So he can just sort of do stuff whenever he wants.
This should be good.
Now, here's the thing. Not everyone at the table has played before. I'm not gonna bust anybody out, but this is supposed to be a happy occasion, which you think would mean I should go easy.
No.
Problem is, this is Vecna.
It's Vecna.
And Vecna's not gonna go easy.
It's not gonna
Vecna's not gonna go easy.
You can method act a little.
Somebody might die here.
You might, but that's okay, because you all are glorious heroes. Glorious heroes. Vecna is, he pulls his finger out in lightning leaps out, going towards you as he casts chain lightning. So, all of you give me dex saves.
Oh, great.
Dexterity?
I'm not
dexterity saves, yes. Lady Applejack, you
good.
Are particularly agile, so 11. It is very difficult to hit you with this.
16.
23.
23. 11. That's not going to be enough to dodge.
Lady
this
Applejack,
thing.
You were able to spring out of the way, basically by ducking behind your friends, who can kind of take it in the chest.
Oh, fun.
Five.
Do I have a shield?
You do. Your shield is a
pretty kick-ass one.
You do. In fact, your shield specifically can help you against things like this.
I know.
You get to roll twice.
Okay.
And take the higher one of those.
Two 20s?
Yeah. Well, yeah, you've already rolled once. You get
to
roll again.
I rolled once, I got a 5, I'll roll again.
Mm-hmm.
11. Oh, man.
Well, the good news is Lady Applejack gets out of the way. That's let's so okay. let's start with a win here.
Oh,
you know, let's start with a win. The rest of you are unfortunately not quite
yeah,
so
Yeah, do
lucky.
What you do, okay. Just yeah. run.
We'll just pray that I roll poorly. That's all you gotta do.
Do what you do best. If that last time I got attacked, it was like almost half our hit points.
Yeah.
There's I probably will only I've have still got two left.
Wait, so there's can a pretty we, big spectrum. This, you guys yeah. have varying levels of tankiness. Yeah. Here, so let's see.
We've got a high constitution.
That's not terrible. That's not terrible. That's only gonna be 25 points of lightning damage.
Okay.
It's not terrible. But not Lady Applejack.
Okay.
25
points of lightning damage.
And I have 21 hit points left.
What are you at?
Is that right?
You're currently at 21 left? Okay, perfect.
I'm at 48. I'm at like 50.
How is that possible?
I have 115 at start.
He is.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I started with 80 something.
You're not all the same.
Because I'm a human.
Pardon me, Bell.
25 damage. I'm on 28.
Vecna looks down at all of you and says, "You could just give up. Join me. Serve me. I will make it sporting for you." And he starts to float down towards the ground.
He's cocky. This is where we get him.
There would
he's
be
cocky
no glory
now.
If I were to just obliterate all of you out of hand, would it?
Looks like I'm on. Yeah.
I don't know, this guy kind of backs himself. I might join him.
No,
this guy's
Stella.
Awesome. I kind of like this
he
guy.
He has Stella.
I want to join him.
He has Stella.
Pardon me, Belching. Dude, it is your turn.
It's my turn.
I want to go and join him. Sorry.
I see okay. you thinking about Joe Keery. Ponder it. It's still time.
When Joe Keery gets offered an independent movie.
Joe Keery will never join him.
This is what you must understand.
I need
you can live and serve me, or you can die. And serve me.
Yes. Pardon me, Belchin. It is your turn.
You don't scare me because I am not afraid of death. That's what I have against you. You live off of fear. A fear of what? Nothing but malarkey. That's all it is. That's all it is. And I would have gotten
malarkey.
Malarkey!
I'm the greatest lich in the multiverse. I'm the master of death.
Oh, the master of death?
Well, malarkey.
Malarkey.
Well, I dig graves, good sir. And I know that it's nothing. It means nothing, not to me at least. And I will a guiding bolt do anything here?
So. Yes, you have a few options.
I figured.
We have a few things you can do.
Go through those options for me, please.
Yes,
thank
you. You can guiding bolt him.
Yeah.
You can try and heal your friends. You can do a pretty significant amount of healing to everyone if you so choose. Mm. Basically, you can heal one person for a lot or everyone for a little.
Here's right? the thing. I would love to heal everybody for a little, but you're all so low on health anyway that if I do that and he hits us once again, we're still gonna
yeah,
die.
Yeah,
I think it's a waste of a go.
I think it's a waste of a go.
Perfect.
However, I'm trying to think of who here has the best shot of messing this dude up if I were to genuinely get a good amount of help going. But I think if anybody here is gonna be any match, it's gonna be me. Sorry, guys, I know it sounds selfish, but...
No.
I think
doesn't sound so.
What I will tell you.
Tell me now.
Next round, if you want to coordinate with Lady Applejack, there might be some stuff you could do. She's already gone in this round. Next round, you guys can do something. Right now, you got your guiding bolt.
Because a guiding bolt, if I send a guiding bolt his way, it ups the damage for the next turn for her, right?
It does.
Yeah.
You also have something called Dawn, where you can call down just like a burning pillar of sunlight that will stay there on him if you want, also.
What will that
do? It's just a spell. That'll burn. Set him on fire.
I'll set him on fire. Yeah. I like fire.
Mm-hmm. Would you like to cast Dawn?
You know what? Honestly, I think I want to go for like a Hail Mary here, and I want him out of here, and I think the best way of doing it is to link up here. I know we've had our differences, but I hope you'll pull through.
I'm gonna go with Lady Applejack's still here?
Yeah, I know, right?
Guiding bolt?
I'm gonna go with the guiding bolt.
Perfect. Now, again, since I'm introducing this in layers of complexity.
Of course.
You can actually cast a bigger guiding bolt. You can cast it at a higher level.
I want
to make
it do more damage.
The biggest of bolts, I assume. You wanted the biggest of bolts. Roll this d20 for me.
Should I just roll it on the screen or can I just roll it here?
Whichever you like.
This is more fun.
Yep.
13.
That actually is enough.
Whoa!
Yes, that is enough to hit him. You are gonna roll 10d6.
10.
You can either, you can do it here. 10 of those bad boys.
5, 6.
Mm-hmm. It's a group effort.
7, 8.
Yep. Pull those sixes.
10.
Yep.
All right, get ready to do some math.
High math coming in. And the guiding bolt.
We got a 6.
Mm-hmm.
We got a 3.
Mm-hmm.
We got a 3.
Mm-hmm.
We got 2 2s.
Mm-hmm.
We got a 1.
Mm-hmm.
We got a 5.
Mm-hmm.
We got a 4.
Mm-hmm.
And we have 2 1s.
Give me the total.
Oh, shit. I didn't make it out of here. Uh-oh. 2 6 12.
I'm gonna show you an easy trick, by the way.
I think 29.
29, perfect. All right, I don't need any easy tricks. 29, all right, perfect.
I was definitely using my fingies to count under the table. I don't know if the camera caught me.
There is no shame in fingies. I mean, like, that's what got Vecna into this mess.
I wanted to sound cool like I was good in my hands.
You know, that is his missing eye hand there, you know, right? But it wasn't obvious.
That
is the eye and hand of Vecna.
That's where I found that. Dude, I got you.
I know, I want it back.
Oh, sorry, bro.
Perfect. You blast him and he begins to glow radiantly. And just looks down at his hands again. And actually, roll that d20 one more.
It's a 13 again.
Okay, perfect. Okay. You shot him. It's great. Just he had advantage because
that'd
of the fairy fire.
That would have been
perfect.
Just for curiosity's sake.
However, he is now glowing, Sir Chadwick, with the guiding bolt. It is your turn. He is undead.
I just want to attack.
You are good at this. Roll your 2 attacks. You run up on him.
So two d20s?
Two d20s, yep. You just roll them both.
8.
That is not going to be enough, even with your significant attack bonus.
Come on, buddy.
Mm-hmm.
20!
20, Nat! 20! Oh, no.
So, no, this is good. Okay. This is good. That was my thinking face.
Okay,
that wasn't a bad face.
That sucks for you face.
So. You are about to inflict a significant amount of damage on Vecna. I assume you would like to smite him.
Yes.
I assume you would like to hit him as hard as you possibly can.
Absolutely.
Right? Mm-hmm. Perfect. You know what? Let's stack this up. I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt here. You have a few spells you can use that would actually make this worse, if you like. You have what is called a branding smite, where your sword will catch on fire.
Any other spells?
Not well. You have other spells, but not that would be directly relevant to this.
Yeah,
I'll try that.
I'll try that. Brandon fire
smite
spell.
Him too. Yeah. Perfect. Okay, so you roll that your damage there, which is I believe that was a D10. D10 plus 6. Roll that, and then you're gonna double that number.
70.
Come on.
So 7 will be 14. 19. And then your smite is going to go off. He is undead, so you hit him for extra. And let's see how hard you are gonna smite him. So you hit him for 19, and he looks down for a second and opens his mouth like he's about to say something, and the smite goes off. A blinding flash where you hit him for another 60 points of damage.
Whoa!
Blowing chunks off of him
and
staggering him backwards. And this is the first time he looks at you and you see the slightest hint of fear in his eyes.
That's awesome.
As he stumbles backwards here. From your divine smite. Perfect. This is a good round for you guys. But that brings us to the top of round 2. Jokiri, it is your turn again. Vecna is on the ground now. Your friend has engaged him. What would you like to do?
Is there, you mentioned earlier that these two could team up.
Yes.
Can I team up with someone and kind of do something bad to him?
There's a specific ability that he has that works really well with an ability that she has. Okay. That's why. So it's not that you can't cooperate. It just so happens they synergize quite well.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. We're locked and loaded here.
We've already started casting. Yeah, mm-hmm. That's okay. I guess I'll stick to shooting him again.
Shoot him. Roll it twice.
Shoot him again.
Mm-hmm.
So that's 15 to start with.
That is not enough to hit him.
Mm-hmm.
Go for it again, buddy.
It worked last time.
It did work last time.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Feel it.
Bring it in.
Feel it. 20.
That's not bad.
Total 20. That is not enough to hit him. He, and you see the arrow arcing right towards his one remaining eye. And he just breaks it, throws it down.
Oh, he's making a fool of me.
Yeah, you were the fool to think you could face Vecna.
I hate him, I hate him.
it's not how many hit points have you got left?
I've got 28.
Oh. And how many have you got left? No, you got
one. I've got 48.
And Lady Applejack, how much?
21.
I dropped the ball. It might not be.
No, he's gonna do it. You give me con saves again. He's going to hit you all with the life drain again. Here's the problem, you all. He does 42 points of damage if it works. He does 21 even if you succeed. He is going to stop Sir Chadwick no matter what. Lady Applejack has a chance to get out of this though.
So I'm dead.
Well, death is a kind of complex process. Trust but you're about me, to be knocked more, unconscious.
Oh, okay.
You're about to be knocked unconscious. My hit points, all of you.
So if my hit points are gone, it doesn't mean that I'm like dead.
Correct.
Got it.
It's a fairly complex process of how to die. But all of you, give me con saves. Wow. Constitution saves, everybody.
Constitution, yeah, that's where I should.
Again, you kind of, still give it to me, Sir Chadwick, because it might matter whether or not you're at zero or at
9.
I got 11.
11? What was it?
15.
11? Okay.
15.
How many hit points did Lady Applejack have?
21.
Okay, perfect.
Both
Lady Applejack and Sir Chadwick collapse to the ground. How many hit points have you got left?
I've got 11. I've 28 left.
You did not make the save. That means you took 42 points.
And the only
of damage.
It might.
Pardon me, Belcher.
Yeah.
Your friends collapse.
Yeah.
Around you.
Uh-huh. I take 21 points, did
21
I?
21 points. Well, no, actually, I don't think you, did you make
15.
It.
I made 15.
42 total.
42 total.
How many do you have?
I have 7.
7. Your friends collapse. Vecna looks down at them.
6, sorry.
The foolishness of mortality. Look at you. All your good works, all your grand adventure, only to collapse in ruin before me. So, what now?
Yeah.
Do you think you can strike me down, cleric? Fine, try your best. I won't even intervene.
I have this rage and this need to just, well, not smite, because you do that, but I have this rage and need to just chuck the hammer at full force towards his head, but I understand that death works in mysterious ways, and I know now that in a time in which I feel, I think I need to be as selfless as possible here. I need to help. The only way I think it's going to work is if I keep being a team player, so I'm going to use that healing spell we talked about before.
The healing word?
Not like the one, the mass one, like the one, right. I'm going to heal the crap out of her.
You can do that as a bonus action. It's not going to heal her by much, but it will get her back to her feet, and you can still do something
else. I thought so. Okay, great.
Still
great,
can
great,
do
great,
something
great.
Else.
Okay, great. Okay. Mm-hmm. Hi.
Hi.
Welcome back. How you feeling?
He is only going to be able to-
garbage, yeah. Right?
Yes, yeah. You come back to consciousness.
Okay.
Everything's hurting, Lady Applejack. Okay. You are still grievously wounded, but you are back in the fight.
Uh-huh.
Yes. And what else would, pardon me, Belchin, like to do?
I have to go. I'm not used to playing magical creatures. I'm used to going the ranged route, but I gotta look at these spells. I'm gonna do Path to the Grave.
Gonna mark him with the Path to the Grave.
To the Grave.
So, what that is, you are a grave cleric. You can basically make him vulnerable to the next thing that hurts him.
Yeah.
The next
That's
attack.
That's right, that we were talking about it before.
Yes.
Okay, great.
You're gonna mark him.
Yeah.
Are you gonna say anything when you mark him with the Path to the Grave?
Surprise, motherfucker.
Lady Applejack. Okay. Technically, you were unconscious for your turn, but you know, again, we're here to have fun. So I'm gonna go ahead and let you take your action now. As you get back to your feet, it seems like Vecna either hasn't noticed you or is just ignoring you. So, go ahead and roll. You can roll twice and take the higher one.
Eight. Okay. Oh, 20! 20! No, for real. Like, actually, for real. Like,
you are the luckiest.
For real.
No!
You're
the luckiest.
That is so silly.
Wait, for real.
I need you to know something. He still has so many hit points, but this means you are going to do 4 times as much damage. So here's how this is gonna work. You are gonna roll 7d6. So give her 7 of these.
You got a couple there. So you got.
Yeah, I think you have enough.
3, 6, 7.
And then give her 1d8 if you would. There, just help her find
the d8. Yeah, that's this guy, right?
It is.
Cool.
And you're also gonna give her one of these triangles. Give her d4.
Yes.
Would you clear all those out? Just make it simple. Okay, you're gonna roll all of that, and you're gonna do 4 times that much damage to him. Jeez, I cannot believe that you are actually literally about to kill him.
Okay.
All right.
30. I think 26.
26.
So now you do 4 times 26 damage.
Yeah. You can do.
So that would be
26.
You're gonna do 104 points of damage to him. He had 102 left. So
you did something!
That was
Tell me what it looks like when Lady Applejack kills Vecna. Okay. What does she do to him?
So Lady Applejack goes in with a stab.
Mm-hmm. Goes in with a stab.
She slices his head off.
Ooh.
Then she stabs him in his eyeball.
Ooh,
one eyeball.
Lady Applejack.
Then he goes in, she goes in for like a stab with like a head split. Like
ooh.
A
fun.
Yeah.
Like that.
You see he opens his mouth like he's about to say something else and down the middle.
Yeah.
And his body collapses and that book falls out.
Oh, the book.
And everything around you begins to ripple and shimmer, and the darkness passes away, and you're back in Hawk's End.
Oh,
and you see all the people are standing there looking confused.
Yeah.
But the book, Joe. The book. As you're staring at it, it looks like it is made out of flesh of some kind, with the face like a growling demon carved in the cover of it, and there are metal bindings down it. And it's like it's whispering to you, Joe, Joe, Joe.
Mm. Oh, I've got to read this
now. Yeah.
And as Joe reaches out for the Book of Vile Darkness.
Wait, I didn't know it was called that.
I think that is a wonderful place for us to stop. Gotta save something for the sequel, right?
Yeah. Oh, man.
Congratulations to you all.
Congratulations
to you. Yes, you killed Vecna, yes.
Crazy.
I need you to know, I absolutely would have killed all of you. And let that be the end of the story. Be like, I guess Vecna wins. That's the ending. So, we rolled the dice and landed on a level 20 good time.
Yo!
Thanks to the Hellfire Club for playing. Glorious Lady Applejack. Thank you at home for watching Netflix Geeked. And until next time, go out there, roll some dice, and have some fun. Thank you all so much. Bye-bye.